silencing my every fear. Jehovah is your name, mighty warrior, great in battle, Jehovah is your name. Sing along with me. Jehovah is your name. Mighty Jesus, Jehovah is your name. O Lord, mighty warrior, great in battle, Jehovah is your name. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, you are Jehovah, the King of kings. Your power and your rest forever and ever. Oh, praise His holy name. Let's go ahead and bless the name of the Lord, who has been fighting our battles for us. The Lord God of miracles, the God of signs and wonders, magnify Him for the victory He has won on your behalf, for His grace upon your life, for His loving kindness. Remember all the battles you fought, but for the Lord, by now those battles will have taken over and overtaken your life. Just magnify the name of the Lord. Glorify Him right now for His mighty hands, for His grace, for His loving kindness, for His support, for His backings, the Almighty God. Begin to bless the Lord for your yesterday. Magnify the name of the Lord for your today. And begin to thank Him in advance for your tomorrow. Glorify Him for what He has done for you. Magnify Him for what He's doing for you and all the things that He will yet do. Just glorify Him today. Remember all that the Lord has done for you and say, Lord, I want to say thank you. King of glory, I want to say thank you. Lord of lords, I want to say thank you. Eternal Rock of Ages, I want to say thank you. Thank you because you are the only one that is able. You are the only one that is constant. You are the only one that is mighty. You are the only one that speaks and it is done. Take all glory, Lord. Take all honor. Take all adoration. For in Jesus' marvelous name, we pray. Amen. I believe you have been waiting for this hour, and you have a particular issue to commit to the Almighty God. Go ahead right now. Say, Lord, today I'm here before you one more time, committing all certain cases into your hand. Answer me like never before. Magnify your name in my case like never before. Smile on me like never before. Settle my case like never before. Pray that prayer. You've been waiting for this hour. You've been waiting for this moment. You've been waiting that very soon prayer rain will soon commence. And here we are right there in the standing before the Almighty God. Now the Lord is saying, what do you want me to do for you? Go ahead right now and call upon the name of the Lord. Do not forget that the Bible says they looked unto Him and they were radiant and their faces were not ashamed. Do not forget that the Bible says they called upon Him and He answered them. Bless the name of the Lord because He's here right now. And go ahead and call upon His holy name. Oh yes, Lord, those that are called upon the name of the Lord, He has answered them. That is why His word says, he that asketh receiveth, he that seeketh found. Those that have been knocking the door has been opening for them. Because the Almighty God is in charge, all right now, of answering prayers. He answers prayers. This our God answers prayers. Don't be tired right now. Commit that your family to His able hand. Commit your life to His able hand. Commit your tomorrow to His able hand. Commit your career to His able hand. Commit your marriage to his able hand. Commit your business to his able hand. Just commit everything to his able hand right now. He's the Almighty God, he's the King of glory himself, the Lord of Lords himself. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. O Lord, our God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. How wonderful is your name, our Redeemer and our God. How marvelous is your name in heaven and on earth. How wonderful is your name, O God of wonders, the only one who performs wonders. Everything about you is full of wonders. Everything that you do, they are all done in a wonderful way. We bless your holy name, O Lord, for your wonders in our lives, for your wonders around our lives, your wonder behind us, your wonder before us, your wonder around us. We thank you for the wonders that you performed in our lives yesterday. We thank you for the wonders you are performing in our life today. And we want to thank you for the wonders you will begin to perform, even by the time we enter into our tomorrow. Oh, yes, Lord. Even ourselves as human beings, the Bible says we are fearfully and wonderfully made. We bless your name, Daddy God, God of wonders, God of miracles, God of signs. We want to say thank you. Thank you for the salvation of our souls. Thank you for our healings. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you for everything you'll be doing in our lives, O God. We want to say thank you very much. Please, Daddy, accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. Oh, God of miracles, we are here today to call upon you, that which no man can do, Almighty God, do in our lives today. So case your supremacy. Demonstrate your almightiness. Let it be said today that the Lord God indeed has met with us. And that, oh God, that which known as signs and wonders and miracles, let it be performed in our lives. And at the end of it all, let that be salvation, let that be healings, let that be deliverance, and let only your name be glorified. Thank you, Father, for having answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. To this God who performed miracles, lift up your hand and shout, Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Today, we are going to focus our attention on the message titled, God of Miracles. God of Miracles. In John chapter 2, verse 11. John chapter 2, verse 11. This beginning of miracles, did Jesus in Cana of Galilee and manifested forth his glory, and his disciples believed on him. What our Master Jesus is known for is that he does what no man can do. Everything about this our God is miraculous. His birth, his life, his death, his resurrection, everything about him. They are all in one particular, may I call it, caption, miracles. To the sense that When the first miracle took place, even those who had been following him, those who had been disciples, the Bible says they believed on him. They saw something that beyond human reasoning, something that cannot be proved by any scientific method that our master performed. And that happened to be the first miracle. But thereafter, there are miracles upon miracles upon miracles. How many can we number? In fact, when we were given the New Testament, they said, this is just few. Because if they were to record everything concerning Jesus, there's no place to put the books. And here, today, by his grace, as we consider this God of miracles, I'm trusting the Almighty God for you. Whatever is the miracle that you need, it will release into your life. In John chapter 2, verse 23, John chapter 2, verse 23, and when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover, in the feast day, many believed in his name when they saw the miracles which he did. He started a miracle. He continued in performing several miracles. So when the people saw the miracles which he did, they believed on him. And in Obadiah chapter 1, verse 17, the book of Obadiah, chapter 1, verse 17, the Bible says, upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. In other words, this God of miracle we are talking about is also the God of deliverance. So in his miraculous way, he has a way of setting people free from whatever bondage they were in. Now, we have been reading his miracles in the Bible and in history. But today, we want to talk about what he's doing in our own time now. 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 And we will key into all these miracles we are going to read, to let us know that, as the Bibles have said, that is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13:8. This Jesus is alive right now to perform his miracles in your life. You permit me to read these testimonies. This one has just been read today, in this month of June, year 2023. So when we are talking about this God, it's not God that we are far away yesterday. That is the special thing concerning our Master Jesus. What he did yesterday, he does today, and we continue to do it tomorrow. Now, let's listen to the testimony of a woman. And it's anonymous. Her name is not mentioned because of the sensitivity of that particular testimony. Brethren, I pray the God of RUCCG prayer ring for the great mercies he has shown to me. My son was a heavy drug addict, and according to him, he was smoking the highest grade of drugs. He was behaving too wickedly and has caused the family serious pains. He left school and refused to go back. He sold most of our expensive properties and stipends just because he wanted money to smoke. He did not care about whose heart he broke. Life became a nightmare to me. Though a widow struggling to make ends meet, I wished to die, but death refused to come. Praise God, brethren, with me. As I continue praying and lifting up my prayer request to God on the prayer altar and keying to other people's testimonies, my son came to confess his faith in Christ on his own. He repented and has never gone back. He stopped all his vices. Even his younger brother that joined him to be smoking, he has been persuading him to stop and turn to Christ. He has also confessed so many things he did and has been assuring me that with God's help, he will make me happy again. Now, he attends church services and including pigeons willingly. He has also chosen a skill to learn and practice why he served God for the rest of his life. Please join me to praise this amazing God. You can see what we are talking about. A child. The devil decided to ruin the life of that child. And the mother happened to be a widow. The father of that child had died, and he began to sell all properties in order to smoke. You can see how bad the devil is. But this woman, the mother, called upon the name of the Lord, and the Lord, who is in charge of deliverance, stepped into the matter and delivered that child. I don't know the trauma you are passing through in your home. Somebody in your home, perhaps that is giving you certain kind of headache, certain kind of heart attack. Imagine this woman, a widow, I quote her again, though a widow struggling to make ends meet, I wished to die, but death refused to come. She wanted to commit suicide because of this child, but somehow the Almighty God rescued her. In other words, no matter what you are passing through now that have been giving you any kind of headache, the Master Jesus is here to deliver that your brother, to deliver that your child, to deliver that your husband, to deliver that your wife, to deliver that your uncle from whatever vices. Call upon the Lord right now. He's standing by your side. Mention the name of that fellow. He's the God of miracles. And he performs deliverance. He performs deliverance. He can deliver that child. He can deliver that brother. He can deliver that uncle. He can deliver. He can show them salvation. See how God met the life, the need of this man. He showed him salvation. Almighty God is great. He delivers, brethren. The Almighty God delivers. Go ahead and call upon the name of the Lord. The Lord God is here right now. He had done it in the past. You remember in the Fiddlers that the Lord met, recorded in the Bible. And here in our own time, he still delivers. He still sets free. The Lord God is here. Call upon the name of the Lord for that individual. Call upon the name of the Lord for that person that has given you a kind of headache, a kind of trouble, a kind of sorrow, a kind of pain in your family. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Perhaps we call the families together to talk to this boy, talk to this girl, talk to this woman. But all their conversations have been able to do nothing. At time, we come a psychological therapist in order to help us cancel him. Let cancel him. But let me tell you, there are level of demonic attack that no counselor in this world can remove. But the Lord Jesus Christ is mighty in battle, and I'm trusting him. He listens to you right now. He listening to you right now. Listening to you right now. It will deliver your family. It will deliver your child. It will deliver him right now. Thank you, Father God, because you are mighty. You are glorious. You are mighty. You are special. And as the certain individual are calling upon you right now, let it be known that you are still alive. Let it be known that you are still powerful. Let it be known that you are still the Almighty. Let it be known that you are still the deliverer. Deliver, oh God, any member of their family or that their friend that is engaging one crisis or the other, let your name be glorified. Deliver that child from that drug addict. Deliver that child from that alcoholic. Deliver that child from all kind of vices that fellow is passing through right now. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. Honor be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Stay on the matter of deliverance. Listen to the testimony of another woman. This testimony also was read in the last meeting that we had on the prayer ring platform. It's also anonymous because of the sensitivity of the matter. I quote, "I thank God for remembering my family. My marriage is about 37 years old, blessed with godly children, with a son-in-law and grandchildren. But my husband is actively into adultery. I have seen and known at least 8 women with him, referred to as his mistresses. He is always with matured women and behaves as if the act is normal, during which he tells people that I'm a witch. This latest one, I assume, began 10 years ago. He starts sleeping with me as his wife since 10 years ago. That is what he does when he's into adultery. He left the master bedroom for me. We are staying in the same flat. He traveled to meet the ones outside our location and attend to the ones in our city. I cannot say all he did to me and our children. I suffered depression 3 times with suicidal attempts. I got treated and came out of it to the glory of God. Then I joined RUCCG, the Redeemed Christian Church of God Prayer Ring, and always key into every testimony of marriage restoration. And I began to pray for my marriage too. Then this year, 2023, on Tuesday after Easter, the miracle happened. My husband told me that if he has offended me, I should forgive him. He then spoke with an elderly woman to speak with me. I thank God for this miracle of confession in his life. And I'm praying that God will heal my children emotionally and every area of our lives. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you see that? How the devil is trying to ruin a family by inflicting the life of the man with the spirit of adultery. And the woman at home, according to her, she suffered depression 3 times with suicidal attempts. She herself wanted to kill herself. Oh my God. The other woman happened to be a child. This woman happened to be her husband. And because we are serving a God who answers prayers, the Lord entered into the life of this man also and removed his life from the spirit of adultery. He came to meet the wife, please forgive me. And in order to let the wife know that he's very serious about this matter, he went to beg an elderly man, please let me beg my wife for me. That was a great miracle. Miracle of compassion. Miracle of deliverance from spirit of adultery, from spirit of fornication. I want you to pray. Are you right there as a husband? Your wife is not faithful. Oh, as a wife, your husband is not faithful. You have been crying. You have been shouting. You have been fighting. And at times, you refuse to give him food. And at times, you pack your bag and baggages and you go. That cannot solve the problem. We are serving a living God who answers prayers. Call upon that God now. That is why we'll be able to read what how terrible the enemy has bombarded certain families, penetrated certain families. But the Almighty God, who is mighty in battle, can deliver. I want you to cry to God right now. The Almighty God will deliver your husband from the strange women. Will deliver your wife from the strange men. And the name of the Lord be glorified. And perhaps your own children, any of your children, they are easy virtue in the society of the wilderness and the market of adultery and fornication. The Almighty God is there. He can rescue them. He can deliver them. Pray right now. The God of miracles, who can deliver from fornication, who can deliver from adultery. That is the Almighty God we are talking about. In the world today, they don't even think again that is a terrible thing, very terrible, that one day the Lord destroys certain people, 23,000 of them in the wilderness. It is so terrible that the Lord can cut off his relationship with anyone that involves in fornication and adultery. Pray right now that every spirit of adultery, every spirit of fornication in my home, Almighty God, by your power, take it out from the heart of my husband. Take it out from the heart of my wife. Take it out from the heart of any of my children. Take it out. Almighty God, purify their heart, oh God. Purify their heart. Purify their heart. Purify their heart. Set my husband free. Pray. I want you to pray for your husband. Set my husband free. You have been discovered. All the quarrel, all the fighting, all this year. The big question is this. How far are the quarrel being able to settle the matter? There's a God who has the power. And when the Lord settles a matter, that matter is settled. Pray right now. Commit that your husband to God's hand. That he perform the miracle there. The miracle of salvation. The miracle of purity. The miracle of holiness. In the mighty name of Jesus. He can do it. He will do it. And he's going to do it for you in particular. In the name of Jesus. I want you to pray. I want you to pray. I want you to pray. Pray with all your heart. Pray with all your soul. Pray with all your spirit. The Lord is here right now. Matore katate. Ye koroko takaye popo. Ye la rabomba la karekese. Ye karapapo. Pray with all your heart right now. The Lord answers prayer. He can deliver from adultery. He can deliver from fornication. He can deliver from sexual immorality. In the mighty name of Jesus. Mataroko sote. Ye karapo meke dakasene. The world is in pollution. It be polluted. With all these vices, but the Lord can rescue you. The Lord can rescue your family. The Lord Jesus can rescue you. He has done it for several others. He can do it for you too. He will do it for you. Pray that prayer, and the Lord will answer you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. Honor be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. I'm trusting God that you have given yourself into this hour to pray. Very soon, we will read your testimonies to the glory of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. Now, let's go to the area of healing, physically speaking. According to Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5, Isaiah 53, 5, the Bible says, when we are talking about healing, with his stripes, we are healed. In other words, because the God of miracles, he does not just deliver only from sexual immorality. He does not just deliver only from drug addicts or whatever. He also heals. He can heal our physical body. He can deliver us from sickness. I love to read testimony. Also, a few hours ago, this testimony came up. I read. Praise the Lord Almighty. My husband was diagnosed of high blood pressure and diabetes all of a sudden after his birthday. He noticed that he had been falling sick and went for a checkup, and he was told he has blood pressure first and later diabetes. I had the testimony of a woman who had healed of high blood pressure and diabetes. Her daughter asked her to stop taking the medication and trust God for her healing. She did and was healed. I keyed into it and told my husband. At first, he was reluctant and later started reducing the intake of the medication and later stopped. He was supposed to go for his monthly checkup, and I told God that I want him to erase those diseases like it was never there. He went for the checkup, and lo and behold, brethren, the result came out negative. The nurse who called him was so happy. You can hear it in her voice. These were people who told my husband that if we have to manage this sickness, help me to thank the Almighty God. Hey, we have read testimonies. We will read some of them very soon. How cancer disappeared. We are talking about this God. My husband, don't take the drugs again. I know a particular God. Who is the God of miracle. They have told you are going to manage it the rest of your life. But this God, I had the testimony. Take the drug away. Initially, the husband fled the doctor. Finally, the husband obeyed the wife. When the test was carried out, they could not trace high blood pressure and diabetes again in his system. That is the master Jesus we are talking about. Not only that, he was healing 2,000 years ago. Till today, he's still in charge of healings. I don't know whether as you are listening, watching right now, you are sick, or you have someone who is sick in your family. Call upon Jesus now. By your stripes, we are healed. By your stripes, we are healed. Call upon the name of the Lord now. He will deliver you today. He will heal you right away. Call upon him. Call upon him. Call upon him. Begin to mention the name. What is the name of that sickness? Begin to mention the name of that sickness. Whatever the name of the sickness or whatever has been diagnosed, every medical report, they have told you this and this. Perhaps they even tag what is happening to you as a terminal disease. Every terminal disease can be terminated by the Lord Jesus Christ. Call upon the Lord right now. Or mention the name of that disease, name of that sickness. Mention the name now. The Lord is by your side right now. He will heal you. He will deliver you from that sickness right now. In the name of Jesus, the pone kasata ye yikuroko totore kazadaba paparoko totore kasandia mlakoroko sete tanrakaton tore kasandayaba. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. Listen to this one, Asabi from Nigeria. He said, just a few hours ago testimony. I was rushed to the UK in November 2021 for the surgery of colon cancer. It was successful and started chemotherapy in April 2022 and committed myself to the Almighty God. And by September 2022, I was declared free of cancer to the glory of God. See how God is moving. Cancer all over the cross. The Lord God himself set this fellow free of cancer. Do you know anybody that is passing through the same? Do you know someone that cancer is disturbing his life? Or perhaps you are directly involved. You are tapping a living God who is here right now. He will deliver you. He will set you free in the mighty name of Jesus. Before I ask you to pray, let me join this one. Lisi from Nigeria also testified a few hours ago. God miraculously healed my daughter from kidney stone disease of 6 years. I always keen to people's testimony of diaper healing by placing my phone on my back as a transfer of power. Kidney stone that have been there for 6 years. For 6 solid years, all kind of medication have been applied to no avail. But the Lord traced where their kidney stone is, removed it by itself, and set that child free. You are going to pray. Whatever the disease, whatever the problem that you have been battling with, that sickness you have been battling with, your end has come today. Almighty God, have mercy on me with your power. Heal me today. Heal me today. Pray. The people who had prayed in the past, the Lord answered their prayers. It is your turn to pray. He will answer you. Pray right now. Whatever the sickness. Kidney problem, lung problem, heart problem, the problem right there in your blood, the problem in your skin, the problem in your eyes, whatever, the problem in your brain, whatever is that problem. We heard before how somebody have some tumor and the tumor disappeared. The Lord God is his name. He's so powerful. He's so powerful that he can cure any disease. Whatever have been the medical report, commit it to God now. He will heal you. He will heal you. He will heal you. He will deliver you. He will set you free right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. Pray unto him. Pray. Pray. Right now. Right now. Are you not praying? Paroko Sataya. Kill that sickness now. He told that he will not kill you. And by the presence and grace of God, no sickness will be able to terminate your life. So terminate the appointment of that sickness now by the power in the name of Jesus. Call out, call upon the name of the Lord. The Bible says, it shall come to pass. Whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Be delivered now from that sickness. Be delivered now from that cancer. Be delivered now. Be delivered. Be delivered. Be delivered. Be set free right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. Honor be to your holy name. Adoration be to your holy name. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen and amen and amen. Now, let's consider the area of security. This Almighty God, the God of miracles, has a way of securing his own people. And when God guides you, then you are truly guided. When God protects you, it is when you are truly protected. And this God is saying, ensure your life in my life. Ensure your life in my hand. And definitely you are protected. Because according to Proverbs chapter 18, verse 10, Proverbs 18, 10 says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. Few hours ago, you know, I'm referring to testimony, not yesteryears, few hours ago, Nkru Nkechi from Nigeria testify. Oh, thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. I told my husband how wonderful the prayer ring platform is. He decided to give it a try. And ever since then, he has not stopped joining. In fact, listen to this. He called the platform his consultation place because of the kind of business he does. Where most people do business with charms. So he now refers to prayer ring platform as his own charm. He considers the name of the Lord now as most potent, whereby you can hide yourself, shoot any arrow. The arrow cannot hit you. 3 days ago, thereabout, we read the testimony of a woman. They were about to have a certain meeting in our office, in our organization. And as she was about to sit, right there on her seat, the Lord opened her eyes and she saw a charm somebody had put on the seat. This word is wicked. Immediately, use the hand, go and burn the charm and so forth. She got back home. She began to vomit and swelling. He said within four times within one hour, he called upon the name of the Lord and the thing stopped. He said the following day, the Lord showed her who did that one, but he should not fight a physical battle because the fellow was surprised. So he's still alive. He's still alive. When the Lord protects you, you are indeed protected. And the Lord is here today to guide you, to protect you. May I tell you a secret? Roots, leaves, incantations, any form of diabolical thing will disappoint a man. Go and ask the prophet of Baal in the day of Elijah. They cried to Baal, but didn't answer them. And you know what? If Baal had not been answering them, they would not call upon Baal that day. But the crucial moment when somebody with a battle to be put to shame, that is where whatever you rely on in this world will disappoint you. But with God, your security is certain. Your security is secured. So if I call upon him today, Jesus, be my all, my garment, my covering, my seed, my shelter. I surrender my life to you today. Be everything concerning me. I commit the totality of my life into your hand. God, take over. God, take over. Almighty God, take over. King of glory, take over. Lord of lords, take over. Eternal rock of ages, take over. I am that I am, take over. And let the name of the Lord be glorified. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Ha! And what about raising dead thing in your system? Whatever is dead there in your system, he had the power to resurrect it. For example, Anonymous also testified a few hours ago, I thank God for joining this program through my pastor's wife since August last year. My prayer life has received a new turnaround. Now listen to his testimony. Before now, I have not been performing well as husband. But ever since that day, I put my gadget on my private part and key into some testimonies. My potency had been fully restored. This testimony of somebody. You know, during that time, the Lord led us that the gadget they are using for the program, they should lay that gadget whatever they know is their problem. So he lays his own gadgets on a private part in his reproductive organ. And the potency God restored immediately. You can see how God is moving around. So whatever is dead in your body, your hand, you are paralyzed, your leg, you cannot walk, or certain things is not functioning well, call upon the name of the Lord now, and you are going to see how the Almighty God will fight your battle for you. Call upon him. Call upon him. Lord, every good thing in my life that is dead, let there be life. Let there be resurrection. Let there be life. Let there be resurrection. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. We are going to round up here today. And I trust in God. The prayer you have prayed today, the Lord has answered expressly to the glory of his name. That's the reason why God is calling you. Surrender your life to him. Yield your totality of your life to him. Call upon him right now. Jesus, come and save me. Let your blood clear my sins away. Let my name be written in the book of life. If you can do that one, you are going to discover the goodness of God and what salvation is all about to the glory of his holy name. And we'd love to hear from you, please. Write to us, rccgprayering@gmail.com. And all the contact addresses will be displayed on the screen after this particular episode. To God be the glory. Lift up your hand now, everybody, wherever you are. Daddy, because you do answer prayers, that is why we have come today to call upon you. Let it be known to all that call upon you today that you are alive by the virtue of the way you'll be answering their prayers. I pray, Lord, that all the prayers today, let all be expressly answered and let your name be glorified. That by your special grace, God of miracles, you will showcase your supremacy, you will demonstrate your almighty, and you prove to all that you are indeed God of miracles to the glory of your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Wherever you are, shout, Arisani, hallelujah.